Hello student, at last lecture we have seen the methods of preparation of alcohols, phenols and ethers. Now today we are going to learn next point of this chapter is chemical properties of alcohols and phenols. Then first of all, chemical properties of alcohols. In this first reaction, that is reaction due to breaking of OH bond. In this reaction, that is OH bond can break in this reaction of these alcohols and phenols. In this first reaction, esterification. Esterification means formation of ester from alcohols and phenols by using carboxylic acid, acid anhydride and acid chloride. Then first reaction, reaction with alcohols and carboxylic acid. In this reaction, this alcohol and carboxylic acid react in presence of H2SO4 and it gives, that is, ester. This reaction is called as esterification. In this reaction, this OH bond of this alcohol break and it gives ester. Then second reaction also with aroma phenol, that means AROH, is again react with carboxylic acid, that is RCOOH. Again here this OH bond breaks here and it forms, that is, aromatic ester. Then second reaction, reaction with acid anhydride. Again first reaction with alcohol, ROH means alcohol. If this react with, that is, acid anhydride having formula RCOOCOR, this R may be same or different. Then again it gives, that is, ester RCOOR dash, this bond get break here and also this bond get break here and it forms RCOOR dash. And another byproduct is carboxylic acid, that is R-COOH. Then third reaction with acid chloride. Acid chloride having formula R-COCl, acid chloride. Again this react with alcohols or phenols. For example, suppose here first of all if react with alcohols, ROH plus R-COCl. Here again this bond break here, that means bond of oxygen and hydrogen. This reaction is carried out in presence of pyridine. Again it gives, that means, ester RCOOR plus HCl. This pyridine is used for this neutralization of this HCl. Then second reaction, that is second one, acetyl derivative of acetyl derivatives. Then what is acetyl derivative? Acetyl derivatives are acetate esters of alcohols and phenols. For example, that means this aspirin. Aspirin is acetate derivative of this salicylic acid. This is salicylic acid. If this react with acetic anhydride, that means CH3COOCOCH3. This is called as acetic anhydride. That means this is anhydride of acetic acid. Then again in this OH bond get break here and it forms, that means this CH3CO get replaced to this hydrogen atom and it gives aspirin. In this way these are called as acetyl derivatives. Then second reaction, that is acidic character of alcohols and phenols. Then first of all, that is acidic characters of alcohols. If these alcohols ionize with water, then it gives, that is, alkoxide ion. It forms this alkoxide ion. In this alkoxide ion, this R is electron donating group and it shows plus inductive effect, that is plus I inductive effect. That means it does not ionize due to this plus inductive effect much in water and it shows the neutral nature in this water. In this way, these are alcohols are neutral in nature. Then second, that means phenol. If this phenol ionizes, then it gives phenoxide ion. It gives phenoxide ion. This phenoxide ion, this resonance stabilized by delocalization of this electron towards this benzene nucleus. Then phenol ionized moderate extent. In this way, phenol ionized in moderate extent and shows, that means weak acidic character. Phenol shows weak acidic character. Then third reaction, that is reaction due to breaking up RO bond or breaking up CO bond. In this reaction, there are reaction with primary alcohol and secondary alcohol. At first, this primary alcohol, that is RCH2OH, if this react with pyridinium chlorochromate, then it gives aldehyde. In presence of pyridinium chlorochromate, in short PCC, it gives aldehyde. But if this react with, that means common oxidizing reagent, that means potassium permanganate, potassium dichromate or nitric acid, then at first it gives aldehyde, RCHO, and after this it again gives carboxylic acid. It gives two product. If this react with potassium permanganate, potassium dichromate or nitric acid, it gives at first aldehyde and then carboxylic acid. Then reaction with secondary alcohol, RCHOHR dash. This OH group is attached to secondary carbon atom. If this react with secondary alcohol in the presence of chromium anhydride, that is CrO3, it gets oxidized and it gives ketone. That means in presence of primary alcohol gives aldehydes and secondary alcohol gives ketone by reaction, by breaking of RO bond or by breaking of CO bond. Then third, that means this tertiary alcohol is difficult to oxidize or oxidation, because by breaking up carbon-carbon bond. By tertiary alcohol, carbon-carbon bond get breaks here and it gives, that means derivatives of 2-carboxylic acid. In this way, it is difficult to oxidize. In this way, these are reactions of alcohols. Then next one, reactions of phenols. In phenols, mainly there are electrophilic substitution reaction. That means substitution by electrophile in phenols are called as electrophilic substitution reaction. That means this OH group, by delocalization of electron, negative charge at ortho and para position. That means this, it gives the product mainly at ortho and para products. At first reaction, that means halogenation. In halogenation, bromine or chlorine, if react with phenol, that means in presence of water, then it gives a product, it's called as, that means this product is called as 2,4,6-tribromophenol. 2,4,6-tribromophenol. That means at two ortho positions, suppose this is carbon number first, this is second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth. That means substitution at two ortho position and first one para position. In this way, it gives 2,4,6-tribromophenol plus 3 molecules of HBr. Then if this phenol is react with, that means CaCl3 or CCl4 or CS2, then it gives a mixture of two products. Which mixture of two products? First one, that is para-bromophenol. This is called as P-bromophenol. And second product, that is ortho-bromophenol. It gives a mixture of para-bromophenol and ortho-bromophenol. That means there are two different reaction. If this react with in aqueous medium, then it gives 2,4,6 tribromophenol. And if this react with carbon disulfide or chloroform or carbon tetrachloride, then it gives mixture of parabromophenol and orthobromophenol. Then second reaction, nitration. For nitration, if this react with dilute nitric acid, there are again two reactions. First one with dilute nitric acid and second with concentrated nitric acid. If this react with dilute nitric acid, then it gives a mixture of two products. If this react with dilute nitric acid at low temperature, it gives mixture of two products. That means nitro group, NO2 group, gets substituted at ortho position, and in second product it gets substituted at para position. Then it gives, that means ortho nitrophenol. Name of this product is ortho nitrophenol or 2-nitrophenol. Ortho nitrophenol is a common name and 2-nitrophenol is a IUPAC name. And second product, that is para nitrophenol. This nitro product, nitro group substituted at para position, it is called as para nitrophenol or 4-nitrophenol. Again, this phenol is react with concentrated H2SO4. Here it react with dilute H2SO4. And if this react with concentrated H2SO4 and dilute nitric acid, concentrated H2SO4, then it gives only one product. Which product? That means again 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. This is called as 2,4,6 trinitrophenol, or it is also called as picric acid. This product is also commercially called as picric acid. Then third reaction, sulfonation. For sulfonation, this react with H2SO4 at different temperature. If this react with phenol react with H2SO4 at low temperature, that means 293 Kelvin, then it forms orthophenol sulfonic acid. That means sulfonic acid group gets substituted at ortho position and it is called as orthophenol sulfonic acid or 2-phenol sulfonic acid. Then second product, that means at 373 Kelvin, then it gives paraphenol sulfonic acid. This product is called as paraphenol sulfonic acid, or it is also called as 4-phenol sulfonic acid. In this way, this reaction with H2SO4, that means sulfonation, there are again two products. One is ortho products and another is para products. The next reaction, that is oxidation. By oxidation with chromium anhydride or sodium dichromate, then it gives this phenol, it gives a product, is called as benzoquinone. Benzoquinone, it is derivative of ketone. It gives two carbonyl group at, that means first and fourth position, that means at para position. Hence it is also called as para benzoquinone. This product is called as para benzoquinone. Then next reaction, that is reduction. Reduction in presence of zinc. Reduction means here in presence of zinc, this phenol, it gives benzene plus zinc oxide. That means it forms zinc oxide with this oxygen and it forms benzene. And last reaction, that is hydrogenation. Hydrogenation takes place in presence of nickel. In presence of nickel, this phenol get hydrogenated, that means, and it gives cyclohexanol. That means all this carbon-carbon double bond of this phenol get hydrogenated and it gives, that means, cyclohexanol. In this way, there are some chemical reactions of these alcohols and phenols, of this different reaction. First one, suppose esterification, then second one, that is ionization or acidic character of alcohol and phenol. Third one, that is reduction due to breaking of CO bond. Then at last, chemical reactions of phenol. In these, there are halogenation, then nitration, sulfonation, oxidation, reduction and hydrogenation. then we will stop here. Thank you.